Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you are new, I like to share my grocery hauls with you to show you how I meal plan to save money for my family on groceries. So our budget is $300 a month. Last month we did great and we only hit $250. So for September or for October, I hope to hit $250 to $300 as well. Usually it's more $300, but sometimes we can get it down to $250 with meal planning. Now I am doing something different. I'm actually doing a Whole 30 for October. If you don't know what that is, it's like an elimination diet where you take out certain foods that are inflammatory and add them back in slowly to see if it's causing you any problems. I have psoriasis and it's been so bad lately. I'm gonna see if things that I eat are triggering that or not. So a couple of these things are new because of how I'm gonna be eating, no gluten, sugar, dairy, and all of that stuff. So these items are actually from Trader Joe's. I got like 5 items from Trader Joe's. I got these shredded carrots to throw in salads just because it's super easy. It was only 99 cents. I also got these sun-dried tomatoes to cook in a recipe with some chicken, and these were $1.99. One expense this month was this mixed nut butter, but it should last me the whole month, and it has almonds, cashews, Brazil nuts, hazelnuts, pecans. There's no added oil or sugar to this, so that is a great thing, and it's $5.99. I got this coconut aminos because soy is something that can be aggravating to some people, so I am not going to be having any soy for this month, so I got this in replacement of soy sauce, and this was, let me see, this was $2.99. Another thing I got was this balsamic glaze. It was $2.99 as well. Then I got this lemon pepper for $1.99. And I got this 21 seasoning salute. I heard it's pretty good. It was $1.99 as well. And then I got organic rice cauliflower in substitution of rice for $1.99. And I got this spicy Italian chicken sausage. It has no soy, no added oils, no sugar, anything like that in it. And it was $3.99. So that is what I got from Trader Joe's. It was $24. And now I will share everything that we got at ALDI, and then I'll have my meal plan that I can show you so you can see what we'll be doing with these ingredients. So I got these grapes. They were $1.49 a pound. Strawberries were $1.49. Mushrooms were $1.29. The ones that were already sliced were $1.89, so I just get whatever one is cheaper. The mangoes were 29 cents each. The zucchini was 98 cents a pound. I got these diced tomatoes to make some chili. These were 55 cents, so I got 2 cans. And then the tomato paste was 29 cents. The tomato sauce was 29 cents. And then these 2 cans of diced green chilies were 55 cents each. The kids have been liking this yogurt. They'll have it for lunch one day. And we got 2 strawberry and 2 blueberry. These are 39 cents each. And they're pretty big. They're 6 ounces each. I got some Dijon mustard to mix with some olive oil and some seasoning to make some salad dressing, and this was only 99 cents. These French-style green beans were $1.39. Steam bag Brussels sprouts were 99 cents. Over here I got some ground beef. This one was $3.19, and then the ground turkey is our favorite. These were $2.19. I got 3 of them. And then I have a package of hot dogs in my freezer still, but I just got 2 more just to have on hand. Savannah's been like in a hot dog craze recently, so these are 99 cents each. She's also been loving this American cheese. Like, she likes the worst things for you. Like, she's lucky she's only 3 years old, but this was $1.79. My husband wanted this turkey breast. He has this in his sandwich, and this was $2.29. Scarlett also has Caesar salad like every night, so we got 3 bags of this for 89 cents each. And then everyone got to pick a treat today. So Savannah picked French fries. These are $1.89 a bag. So I got 2 of them just so that we can have them in the freezer and avoid any drive-thrus. That saves a lot of money having treats on hand. That's going to keep you from going out to eat. So these were only $1.89 each, much cheaper than anywhere else you can get French fries. My husband picked this cheese ravioli. It's only $2.49. This lasted us like 3 meals, and it is so good. I highly recommend it. It was delicious, so this was his treat. Scarlett chose these potato chips for her treat. These are only 99 cents, and we got 2 bags. We also got a thing of sourdough bread. It was $2.49. We got two vanilla caramel coffee creamers. That salted caramel mocha, I did not like it. It was just, I haven't had mocha in a while. It was just too chocolatey. You couldn't taste any salted caramel, so I didn't like it. But these are only $1.99. And my treat, if you can call it that, is some berry sparkling water. It has no sugar in it. Or any added sugar or artificial sugar. It was only 89 cents. And then we also got a case of water right there for $1.99. So that is our grocery haul. Altogether, it was $80 for both stores. So that was not too bad. And this is my meal plan. So for breakfast, it's mostly going to be a variation of eggs and vegetables, and then some days I will have sweet potatoes with nut butter on it, and I got the sweet potatoes last week when I went to Sprouts. For lunch, I'm basically going to have either a salad or I'm going to have chili, so that's what I am making for the week, and I'll eat that every day. And then for dinner, we're going to have salmon and broccoli, turkey burgers with potato wedges, then we'll have leftovers on soccer night. The next night, we'll have buffalo chicken strips with roasted veggies with leftovers the next night. And then we'll have chicken fajitas with leftovers the next night. It's so much easier to only cook 3 days and have leftovers for the next day to carry over. Then the next week, breakfast will be the same, but for the soup for the week, I'm making a creamy tomato and chicken soup or a strawberry balsamic chicken salad. I'll have one of those two every day for lunch. And for dinner, we're going to use the leftovers of that chicken fajitas to do chicken quesadillas. Then the next night we'll have balsamic chicken with mushrooms and potatoes, then leftovers, then chicken zucchini poppers, then leftovers, then tacos, and leftover tacos. So leftovers are going to play a vital role in this month because we're going to be cooking so much that I want to make sure we don't get burnout. So if it has a C, that's a night we're cooking. So plan out what nights work best for you and your schedule. Wednesdays are really busy for us, so we wanted to do leftovers so we don't have to worry about cooking anything that day. So that is my meal plan. These are my groceries. It should last us about 2 weeks. And yeah, so we spent $80 so far for the month of October. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on our videos to see how much we're able to spend for the whole month and our meal plan for the month as well. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye.